We have just about been an entire liturgical season in lockdown, tears, or whatever we're calling them now. Life as we knew it a year ago is so very different. As Lent looms, are you ready for 40 days of prayer, fasting, almsgiving? Perhaps you're thinking of giving up chocolate or alcohol. Or are you going to do something positive? Walk that extra mile? Volunteer to help a neighbour? So that this season of preparation for Easter can really work a change. We'll surely be then better people when we hit the joy of the risen Christ. We tend to insist on rules and regulations to make us better people. Face, space, save the NHS. We need to feel we're in control. COVID, that gift, shows us just little control we actually have. A hint may be that perhaps we do not need to be in charge. I wonder what God really has in mind this Lent. Do we need to change? Perhaps we just need to allow ourselves to be so that others can accept us as we are. Will that extra pound of chocolate mean God's love will be withdrawn? No, of course not. The consistent experience of the mystics that the Carmelites strive to keep alive is that God is always pouring out love on you, always inviting you into ever deepening relationship. But do you realise there is someone dancing with you who does not mind how many mistakes you make, that extra pound? But are you aware of this invitation? That surely is the point of Lent, to become aware. To be aware, we do not need to fully work it out for ourselves. To be aware, we do not always have to be right. It is enough just to let ourselves be known, to be held in the dance, to let our minds, hearts and bodies become conduits, instruments that resonate that invitation of love and relationship to all around us. To be in such a way is to live inside hope. That hope will make our lives feel so much larger. That hope will weave a web of connections so that all that fear, all that anxiety about whatever, should I be vaccinated? Can I give you a hug? Shall I even venture out? All that will get caught up and dissipated in that magical dance. Is not that the way to keep a true Lent?